One of the positive aspects of agroforestry is we're mixing perennial crops with annual crops. PhD and MSc studies on the farm have shown increased levels of biodiversity, increased levels of spatial diversity of insects.
L'adozione di buone pratiche culturali limita fenomeni di erosione.
Eu acredito que a agrofloresta tenha um papel muito importante na agricultura do futuro.
As agroflorestas afetam o clima por várias razões, não só pelo carbono que sequestram, pelos níveis de carbono, mas essencialmente porque elas são a única estrutura neste planeta que consegue absorver sem outro tipo de consequências, a energia do sol, que é muita.
Often people look at the system, the agroforestry system we've got, and they think we're taking land out of production into trees. I would say it's the reverse. We're actually trying to make the farm more intensive, and we're doing that by trying to capture more carbon and actually use more of the soil below the surface and more of the space above the ground and try and be more productive.
Eu comecei a fazer agrofloresta de uma maneira completamente inconsciente e só me apercebi que fazíamos agrofloresta quando fui visitado por umas pessoas estrangeiras que trabalhavam para a Comissão Europeia e que ficaram muito surpreendidas quando aqui chegaram e me falaram em agrofloresta, porque eu, para mim é o sistema natural aqui da nossa região.
Extra biodiversiteit, dat je gratis bladval hebt, dat er dus organische stof bij komt. Waarom dat ik begonnen ben met agroforestry, ja, is omwille van de voordelen dat je een extra product kan telen gemengd met je akkerbouw eronder.
It ticked many of the boxes that we were looking to try and achieve in terms of increasing productivity, increasing biodiversity, protecting the soil from wind erosion and fitting around our sort of arable farming system.
En vooral, wij zitten in een heel winderige streek in de open polders aan de kust. En daarom wil ik zeker ook van de winter nog extra bomen aanplanten om die wind een beetje meer te breken. Daar hebben die bomen voordeel bij, maar ook gewoon de groenten.
Et je crois beaucoup en ce système-là, en fait, tout simplement pour continuer à produire un petit peu sur ces coteaux. Voilà. Il y avait aussi comme raison l'érosion, parce que là c'est toujours pareil, c'est des coteaux, donc c'est très érosif en fait. Et chaque ligne d'arbre, si elle est plantée en travers de la pente, suivant les courbes de niveau, ben forcément elle crée une barrière mécanique en fait à l'eau et donc au sol. Et donc au sol. Et l'agroforesterie est un des systèmes qui permet ça, qui permet peut-être d'augmenter, de protéger les sols, d'augmenter les taux de matière organique, de faire un petit peu d'ombrage, de réguler l'eau, etc. En fait.
What we have seen is a massive change in biodiversity. There's been a number of studies which have shown increased levels of spatial diversity of insects and increasing the number of pollinators and increasing habitat for them.
De andere insecten, ziektes, plagen in een boomgaard en zeker in onbehandelde bomen, daar krijg je toch vrij makkelijk, vrij goed een ecologisch evenwicht. Zodanig dat je zonder veel ingrijpen, zonder veel gebruik te maken van pesticiden, toch een zeker evenwicht hebt en waardoor dat dus het aantal vruchten dat beschadigd wordt door ziektes, door plagen, relatief beperkt is.
I think it's hugely important for agriculture.
Trattandosi di azienda piccola, produce e dalla pianta e dal suolo, insomma, quindi economicamente sta un po'.
E tra l'altro, diciamo, con le loro deiezioni arricchiscono, anche se non in maniera, diciamo, sufficiente a mantenere la fertilità del suolo, va comunque integrata, però è un'integrazione, non è una fertilizzazione a tutto tondo degli oliveti aziendali.
Senz'altro dal punto di vista ambientale, perché noi non, per esempio, non trattiamo, non concimiamo.
Ja, goed nadenken over het plan hoe dat je het wil aanpakken, de, de plantafstanden en richtingen, de richting van de bomenrijen. Bij ons kwam dat eigenlijk gewoon goed uit dat dat noord-zuid gericht is op de meeste percelen. Ik bedoel dat de werkwijze, of hoe dat we het veld bewerken, sowieso al noord-zuid is. Op één plaats is het oost-west, maar daar heb ik dan gekozen voor die hazelaars en perziken die minder hoog worden en dus ook minder schaduw gaan geven in de toekomst.
For me, when I practice agroforestry, I'm trying to basically implement my observations of nature. So what I'm learning from the natural cycles, I'm trying to replicate. And especially here with mushrooms, we're not doing anything different than the natural forest ecosystem cycle, other than replacing with whatever would have colonized these logs with shiitake mycelium or reishi or whatever else we're growing. So in that way, agroforestry to me, it's closer to nature.
It copies the way that zebras or buffalo would roam around through prairies, grassland, woodlands in history. So we do that by putting them in a small enclosure. I've only got 5 sheep, but I can get an animal density that resembles a big group of wild animals.
Tudva lévő, hogy a ló és a birka nem ugyanazt eszi, tehát érdemes, ha nem is egy időben, tehát én ugyan egyszer a lovakat engedem rá, utána a birkákat, tehát a ló más fűfélét eszik, a birka megint más, és a kecske meg a bokrokat. Tehát én mindenkinek azt javasolnám. Ha teheti, kecske, birka minimum, ha van módja, akkor ló is. És akkor nagyjából megvan a takarás, de, amit az előbb mondtam, hogy a gyom mellé kell a gép, mert kell a gép, azt kikerüli az állat, és ezzel együtt, tehát géppel, lóval, birkával és kecskével talán megnyerjük a meccset.
Yo recursos que emplego para mi ganado son baseados en la naturaleza. Somos autosuficientes, o sea que no mercamos nada de afuera. Alimentación do gado de castiñeiros, por ejemplo, aproveitamos os follatos, aproveitamos ahora, desde que se acaba a colleita da castaña, as castañas, o líquen dos árboles, a folla, os follatos dos rebolos, e aparte deso, ahora nesta época que normalmente está todo axeadado, pois sementamos centeo, pasteno as ovellas, hasta día 20 de janeiro, más o menos.
Dlaczego warto sadzić drzewa na pastwiskach? Mamy dodatkową produkcję drzewną, mamy dodatkową produkcję paszową, tak jak tutaj mamy ulęgałkę, która produkuje nawet do kilkuset kilogramów małych gruszeczek, które stanowią bardzo dobre uzupełnienie paszy dla bydła.
With mob grazing into the woodland, it was purely by accident. It's a hot sunny day today. I try to make sure that there is some shade available to the sheep. So if they're out in the field, then I try to, you know, give them something that's got some shade. And it seemed natural to kind of jump into the woods a little bit just to give them some natural shade. And yeah, they started eating into the undergrowth. So it happened quite by accident. But effectively, it gives me more land to use. And they seem to enjoy it. They eat all the leaves off the trees. It's kind of where I've used this kind of technique, it's changing the way that the farm looks.
Os sistemas agroforestais en Galicia son absolutamente esenciais de cara fundamentalmente a prevención de incendios e a permitir despois un mellor control. E sobre todo son tamén unha parte esencial na economía agraria, porque ten sinerxias entre o sector gandeiro, sobre todo extensivo, e o sector forestal, complementanse mutuamente e ademais sobre todo defendense mutuamente.
Zadrzewienia tego typu dają bydłu w lecie ochronę przed słońcem oraz pełnią funkcję produkcyjną, produkcję drewna opałowego. A na wiosnę można także pozyskać tutaj bardzo dobrej jakości sok brzozowy.
A chuva, a precipitação, está diretamente relacionada com a dinâmica do que nós temos no solo e com as florestas.
One of the attractions for me for agroforestry is that, you know, typically we only think of our crop production about a meter above ground at most, and probably half a meter below ground. Whereas the trees in the system are using more space, so we're trying to capture sunlight for a longer period during the season, and also using more space above and below the ground to actually grow crops. So it's sort of vertical or tiered farming systems. The beauty for us is that the wheat that you can see behind you is capturing its sunlight and nutrients early in the season and turning those into carbon and into cash crop. And then later in the season, when the cereals are actually dying off, the apple trees are still capturing that sunlight and turning it into a crop right through to the late autumn. So we move seamlessly on this farm from cereal harvest in midsummer through to fruit harvest in late autumn.
As nossas grandes dificuldades aqui no Mediterrâneo para aplicarmos os bons princípios de uma agricultura de conservação passam pela gestão que nós fazemos durante o período seco, o nosso verão e hoje em dia o nosso outono. E portanto, sempre que olhamos para sistemas diferentes, eles muitas vezes não nos respondem a essa pergunta em concreto de como é que nós devemos fazer essa gestão. Mas eu, curiosamente, no meu caso, tenho aprendido muito com produtores estrangeiros e através do Afinet tenho... Às vezes são pequenos exemplos que nos fazem umas cócegas no cérebro e que nos põem a pensar de que forma é que nós conseguimos aplicar aquele princípio na nossa realidade.
Days like today are great, these workshops where we bring people together. Everyone has a space to talk about their ideas and what they're doing, and you know, they learn from us and we learn from them, and it's just such a beautiful thing, and I'm really happy that Afinet supports this kind of thing. It's really incredible to bring everyone together and just talk about what's going on. What are the ways of work? What are the things that are, how can we help each other?
Un confronto, una conoscenza di vari attori che comunque confluiscono in questo settore, quindi penso sia importante.
Wel, als je begint met bomen, je hebt nog nooit bomen geplant, heb je eigenlijk in het begin een beetje gebrek aan kennis. En ook omdat je al vrij snel, ik dan toch vrij snel bezig was met verschillende soorten bomen. Het was dus in het begin eiken, maar daarna ben ik overgegaan ook op fruitbomen, notelaars en zo verder. Dan moet je wel heel veel kennis hebben om al die verschillende bomen goed te beheren, te snoeien, maar ook de aanplant kan al verschillend zijn. En ook de verschillende rassen, moet je allemaal een beetje kennis van hebben. En vaak heb je in het begin toch wel wat gebrek aan kennis en ervaring en weet je ook niet altijd direct waar je terecht kunt. Dus dat was eigenlijk wel aanvankelijk een beetje een probleem.
Temos o conhecimento, começamos a alicerçar o conhecimento que nos permite dar passos certeiros e inequívocos nessa construção. Não é?
I think there's a lot of work to do and there's a lot of research and kind of experimenting.
En ik vond dat er wel iets in zat in dat systeem. En dat het meerwaarde had op meerdere vlakken, niet alleen de rendabiliteit, maar ook qua dat het meer natuurlijk was. Meer aansloot bij natuurlijke systemen op de planeet. En daarom heb ik het uiteindelijk toch gedaan.